The people walking in darkness have seen a great light. Those who dwell in the land of deep darkness, on them has light shined.
Darkness. During the winter, we are more profoundly aware of darkness. By 4:30, dusk begins to settle in, and by 5, it's dark.
Darkness. Without Christ's willingness to come into our world as one of us, we would be in darkness, lost and condemned by the hopelessness of our sin.
But today we celebrate Advent, the happy new year of the Christian church year. In Advent, we are reminded that Christ did come, piercing the darkness of hopelessness with the light of his grace.
When Jesus spoke to the people, he said, "I'm the light of the world. Whoever follows me will not walk in darkness, but will have the light of life."
And we call this light Emmanuel, for he is God with us.
Jesus, the light of the world.
Jesus, the reason for the season.
Since the early days of the church, many believers have celebrated Advent and Christmas as two separate seasons. The first season is for preparing and expecting. At Advent, we look forward to not one, but two arrivals. First, we anticipate and long for the birth of Jesus, just as the Jewish people longed for the promised coming of the Messiah, the King who would rescue them and return glory to Israel. Christmas, the end of the Advent season, is a celebration of that promise kept. The Messiah came, the Son of God sent first as a sacrifice for the forgiveness of our sin. But we wait still for him to come again, to return and make all things right, to take his place on the throne forever. At Advent, we prepare ourselves for that second arrival as well, with repentant hearts and joyful confidence that our God always keeps his promises. Come, our long-expected Savior.
Advent is the four-week period leading up to Christmas during which we prepare for the coming of the Lord.
The word Advent literally means coming, and it reminds us of the three comings of Christ.
With each candle that we light today, not only will we remember the light of Christ coming into this dark world, but we will also remember how our Savior and King comes to us.
First, Advent is the time we prepare to remember Christ coming as a baby at the first Christmas so long ago.
On that first Christmas, he entered fully into our human experience.
Philippians 2:7, "But Jesus emptied himself by taking the form of a servant, being born in the likeness of men."
So, Advent reminds us that we have a Savior who knows exactly how we feel.
Hebrews 4:15, "For we do not have a high priest who is unable to sympathize with our weaknesses, but one who in every respect has been tempted as we are, yet without sin."
Today we will look at the two names of God. The first is Emmanuel.
Literally translated, Emmanuel means "with us is God," or as the Gospel of Matthew puts it, "God with us."
Isaiah 7:14, "Therefore the Lord himself will give you a sign. The virgin will conceive and give birth to a son, and will call him
Emmanuel, Emmanuel."
Since our sins make it impossible for us to come to God, he took the incredible step of leaving heaven and making himself human. We call this incarnation. This is
Emmanuel.
Matthew 1:22-23. "All of these took place to fulfill what the Lord has said through the prophet. The virgin will conceive and give birth to a son, and they will call him
Emmanuel."
Yes, God is with us in spirit every day, but at Christmas we remember that Jesus literally became God on earth with us. Our
Emmanuel.
John 1:14, The Word became flesh and made his dwelling among us. We have seen his glory, the glory of the one and only Son, who came from the Father, full of grace and truth.
Only the one true God is our
Emmanuel, Emmanuel.
Please stand and sing, calling on our Emmanuel.
When Jesus tells us he is Emmanuel, God with us, he is saying that he is always here for us in good times and bad. He will never leave us or forsake us. When Jesus tells us he is Emmanuel, he is not distant from us and looks down on us from heaven, but instead he walks with us and beside us and does not leave us behind. Jesus came down to earth and humbled himself and walks with us through our sins. He died for our sins, and he is with us until he brings us up to heaven and we live in eternal life with him.
Emmanuel literally means God with us. To me,
That name is saying more than God with us. That name is saying that God is always with us, and that we should always believe him when he says that he is Emmanuel. He is God that is with us. He doesn't leave us. He guides us and is willing to carry us when we can no longer carry ourselves. That is what Emmanuel means to me.
Emmanuel, God with us. As we light the second candle, we remember that God comes to us every day through his word and in his spirit.
1 Corinthians 3:16. Do you not know that you are God's temple and that God's spirit dwells in you?
Emmanuel is truly God with us.
Romans 8:38-39. For I am sure that neither death, nor life, nor angels, nor rulers, nor things present, nor things to come, nor powers, nor height, nor depth, nor anything else in all creation will be able to separate us from the love of God in Christ Jesus, our Lord.
There is no struggle, no difficulty, no trial we go through alone, for Emmanuel is with us.
Isaiah 41:10. Fear not, for I am with you. Be not dismayed, for I am your God. I will strengthen you, I will help you. I will uphold you with my righteous right hand.
In every joy, every success, every moment of victory, Emmanuel stands with us.
1 Corinthians 15:57. So thanks be to God, who gives us the victory through our Lord Jesus Christ.
What do we see when we behold the first coming of Christ? We see a God who understands exactly what we need, and so his arrival mirrors our need. When we examine that first Christmas, we also see that our God is approachable. When God became a man to save us, he didn't come as a giant shining being that filled all around him with fear and trembling. No, he came as a baby. What can be less scary than a newborn baby? In Jesus, God found a way of relating to human beings that did not involve fear. And that's because God is love. What can compare to God becoming a baby? Nothing. And yet that is what happened at Bethlehem. The God who created matter took shape within it, as an artist might become a spot on a painting or a playwright a character in his own play. God wrote a story using real characters on the pages of real history. The Word became flesh.
He could have come as another prophet of tears, or another son of thunder. He could have come with lightning in his hands, calling fire from heaven, but not this time. This time he came in gentleness, his glory and his thunder alike laid aside, not as an angel of vengeance, but as a man in mercy, not to spy on our sin, but to remove it, not to punish guilt, but to forgive it. His hands are full of gifts of love, and his presence is the guarantee of grace. God came to earth before, but never as a savior. So rejoice, you who feel lost. Your Messiah comes to seek and save you. Rejoice, you who are imprisoned, for he comes to set you free. Rejoice, all who are famished and ready to die. He has come to be the bread of life to your souls. Rejoice, O sinners everywhere, for the restorer of the castaways, the savior of the fallen, Emmanuel, is born.
Our second name of God today is Light of the World.
According to Jewish tradition, one of the names for the Messiah is Light.
Isaiah 9:2. The people who walk in darkness will see a great light. For those who live in a land of deep darkness, a light will shine.
How appropriate, then, that Jesus is called the Light of the World.
John 8:12. Jesus said, I am the light of the world.
Jesus is the light and defeats the darkness brought on by sin, a darkness that ends in death.
John 8:12. Jesus said, I am the light of the world. Whoever follows me will not walk in darkness, but will have the light of life.
Christ opens the eyes of a sin-darkened world to the truth of the gospel.
John 31 to 32. So Jesus said, "If you abide in my word, you are truly my disciples, and you will know the truth, and the truth will set you free."
Therefore, we who believe in him have moved from darkness to light, from death to life.
Psalm 18:28, "For it is you who light my lamp. The Lord my God lightens my darkness."
The third candle is pink because it is the candle of joy.
As we move closer and closer to Christmas, more and more light shines.
We anticipate the joy of our salvation.
The joy we have in knowing that the steadfast love of the Lord never ceases.
The joy knowing that his mercies never come to an end.
For they are new every morning.
Rejoice, the light of the world has defeated the darkness of sin and death.
When Jesus says he is the light of the world, I immediately think of Psalm 119:105. Thy word is a lamp unto my feet and a light unto my path. That pops into my mind because he is lighting up our path, just like he is lighting up the world. He is lighting up our path to lead us the right way, and he is lighting up the world to lead us the right way to heaven.
light of the world. I think it means that Jesus is above all others and that he shines more and above than anyone else. Jesus is the one true God, and he is the most powerful and all-knowing God. If we follow his light, we will have eternal life with him in heaven. Jesus is the only way to heaven, so that makes him the one and only true light of the world.
As we prepare for Christmas, Advent gives us the time to consider the entire reason Christmas even exists. Christmas is all about our greatest need.
If our greatest need had been information, God would have sent an educator. If our greatest need had been technology, God would have sent us a scientist. If our greatest need had been money, God would have sent us an economist. But since our greatest need was forgiveness, God sent us a savior.
And today, as we anticipate Christmas, we can know that Jesus became like us so we could become like him. Angels still sing and the star still beckons. And Jesus loves each one of us like there was only one of us to love.
The last candle reminds us to prepare for the second coming of Jesus.
Yes, our Savior will return again. How do we know? He promised, and Jesus never breaks a promise.
Just listen.
2 Peter 3:10, but the day of the Lord will come as unexpectedly as a thief. Then the heavens will pass away with a terrible noise, and the very elements themselves will disappear in fire, and the earth and everything on it will be found to deserve judgment.
Though that sounds terrifying, know this. The light of the world, our Emmanuel, has made a way for each of us to approach his second coming with joy, not terror.
That's the key to Advent. Christ came as a baby to live as a man, to die for our sins, to open heaven for us.
Galatians 4, verses 4 through 5. But when the set time had fully come, God sent his Son, born of a woman, born under the law, to redeem those under the law, that we might receive adoption to sonship.
This Advent, look to this light, for Christ alone can save you.
Jesus came to bring us the greatest gifts. Not gifts that break or fall apart or go out of style. No. In this season of Advent, we remember that Jesus brings the gifts that make all the difference.
Forgiveness. No gift is greater. When we remember the baby born on Christmas, we remember that he came to take our sins away. He was born so he could die in our place. That was God's great plan from before the foundation of the world. The Lord has delivered us from the domain of darkness and transferred us to the kingdom of his beloved Son, in whom we have redemption, the forgiveness of sins. Colossians 1:13-14.
Love. That's why Jesus came to this world, to give us the gift of love. Love. That's why Jesus died. The love of Jesus, our Emmanuel, is the only unconditional love you'll ever experience.
God demonstrates his own love for us in this. While we were still sinners, Christ died for us. Romans 5:8.
Joy. Christ brings us true joy, a fabulous gift. Oh, in this world we may have happiness, but the happiness in this world is brief. Joy is that feeling no tragedy can steal away. Joy is that feeling of confidence we have to face everyday life. Jesus said of the joy he brought, listen. I've spoken these things to you, that my joy may remain in you, and that your joy may be full. John 15:11.
Hope. As Christ comes to us every day through his word and spirit, he brings us the gift of hope. And this hope, this is real hope. Not the I hope the Raiders win the Super Bowl type of hope, but rather the unshakable hope of salvation in Jesus. The kind of hope that makes life worth living. May the God of hope fill you with all joy and peace in believing, so that by the power of the Holy Spirit, you may abound in hope. Romans 15:13.
Victory. In Christ, we get victory.
Only the light of the world can give us victory over darkness of sin, death, and the devil.
If you've never won a thing in your life, know that Jesus Christ brings victory.
And when Jesus comes again in glory on the last day, we will join him in heaven for the final victory.
For you were once darkness, but now you are light in the Lord. Live as children of light. Ephesians 5:8.